In light of looming environmental crisis and economic failures, it has become pivotal for our survival to come together as a unit and work towards sustainable economic growth and development. Yet, we continue to witness how corporations and businesses fail to integrate the essence of sustainability in their models. Hence, a key step towards a better tomorrow remains improvements in modern businesses and innovative entrepreneurial ventures. With this in mind, we introduce to you Enactus Miranda House.
Our journey began in December 2011. A journey embarked upon with the sole purpose of improvement through entrepreneurial action. Where others saw weakness and utter desolation, we saw an opportunity of thriving businesses and prospects of positive social impact by harnessing the existing skills and introducing some new ones. A will to make a difference in the world has led to two new projects. We begin with our first project, Project Ikt.
Namo Yamuna. पदाद्यरेनोधि पवितात्मनि विदिताकिल वेद्याय गुरवे मेदितात्मनि. Meaning, River Yamuna is a holy river that has been worshipped for ages. In India, rivers are considered to be spiritual and regarded as the lifeline of human civilization, providing a basic natural resource. One such river is Yamuna.
Often called the lifeline of Delhi, the Yamuna is now gasping for life. The river accounts for nearly 80% of all pollution in the 1,376-kilometer long river, which caters to the needs of 57 million people. The situation got exacerbated when it was declared ecologically dead by the United Nations.
Water hyacinth is recognized as the world's worst water weed by the United Nations Environment Programme. It is one of the most menacing factors that lead to River Yamuna's pollution. Water hyacinths develop rapidly in the form of thick mats over River Yamuna, which affect the aquatic life underneath the river surface and population along the banks of the river.
This brought us to Lok Kalyan Setu, an urban slum at ITO Ghat, along the banks of River Yamuna, where we observed a similar overgrowth of water hyacinths and the resulting plight of daily wage workers and street vendors struggling to earn a living with no access to clean water.
We believe in turning challenges into opportunities. We believe in Ikhtiyar. Initiated in November 2017, Project Ikhtiyar aims at eradication through utilization by harnessing the hidden potential of water hyacinths to overcome the challenges they pose.
Project Ikhtiyar aims to produce manure using water hyacinth as the main component along with other biodegradable waste in order to clean River Yamuna and improve the economic condition of our community members.
After extraction, the water hyacinth are chopped into small pieces and left to decompose in a customized composting box for 45 to 60 days. Having a well-developed root system, they can absorb important nutrients, making the manure pathogen-free and nutrient-rich, improving its structure and percolation for air and water.
This manure is then packaged in eco-friendly jute bags and sold to several nurseries, colleges, schools across Delhi NCR.
गुलगुंडिया हमने जमने में से निकाली, उसमें गोबर डाला, उसका खाद बनाया, बना के बेची, बेच के पैसा है, घर का खर्चा चलाया.
Since 2018, we have produced 10 batches of manure amounting to 2,480 kgs. In the initial year, we generated a total revenue of rupees 16,800 and increased it to rupees 45,150 at 2020. This has resulted in an upsurge of 168.63% in total revenue from 2018, 240.92% in the individual income of the community members, and a subsequent improvement in the Human Development Index of the community.
Through the extraction of 4,969 kgs of hyacinth and utilization of 465 kgs of biodegradable waste, we have successfully reduced carbon emissions by 0.77 metric tons. River surface cleaning has reduced the breeding of disease-carrying vectors and allows sunlight and oxygen to reach the aquatic life in the river.
We have collaborated with several NGOs like Nanhe Pakshi, Jan Sharnam and Anmol Welfare Society for conducting awareness workshops to ensure holistic development of the community. We take pride in directly impacting 34 members and indirectly impacting 25,384 members through our project. We also conduct regular collection drives for the community. Project Ikhtiyar has been featured in the National Daily, Times of India, showcasing the project as an initiative for social revolution.
Keeping the spirit of Enactus alive amidst the global pandemic, we strive to keep working. We have provided our community with suitable PPE kits to maintain hygiene and ensure continued production. In collaboration with the Robin Hood Army, we reached out to our community members and ensure constant food supply.
Aspiring to bring about a multifaceted impact, under our short-term goals, we intend to use temperature-controlled composting bins, which would maintain a suitable temperature throughout the year. We aim to tap into e-commerce platforms like IndiaMart and Amazon.
Besides, our future outlook involves the expansion of our production and community base by replicating the model in other communities along the banks of Yamuna. We also intend to explore the possibility of producing biogas from water hyacinths.
To think, to imagine, to believe in what can be, what should be, what must be, is to believe in Ikhtiyar. We now move on to our next project, Project Dhreya.
Every year, a cloud of choking smoke descends upon the 25 million residents of Delhi. This recurrent surge in air pollution in Delhi forms a major part of a dangerous pollution problem in India. Chronic respiratory illnesses and obstructive pulmonary diseases are the norm here, not the rarity.
Approximately 23 million tons of crop waste are set afire by farmers from Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. This burning of stubble accounts for 46.6% of Delhi's total air pollution. The lack of funds and non-accessible waste management systems leaves them with no alternatives other than to burn the residue. The excessive dependence of industries on fossil fuels exacerbates the problem.
Ideated in July 2019, Dhreya aims to transform agricultural waste into a cost-effective source of renewable and clean energy. Project Dhreya provides a threefold solution to air pollution caused by stubble burning, low income of farmers and industrial emissions by producing briquettes.
We reached out to a farmers community in Sonipat, Haryana, who own a total land holding of approximately 30 acres. The main crops cultivated are wheat, paddy and sugarcane, fetching them a mere monthly income of 7,083 rupees. Converting crop waste into briquettes adds commercial value to the residue, making it an asset for the farmers and enabling them to earn an additional income.
Our team has created a system to collect the residue left after harvesting using rented machinery. The stubble is then finely ground and a binder is added. The mixture is then compressed into a briquette using a screw press machine and left to dry for a week. The briquettes produced are durable, easy to store and transport.
The market for biomass briquettes is extensive and includes multifarious industries such as refractories, dyeing units and other industries requiring a thermal application.
Scientists from Indian Agricultural Research Institute trained the community in technicalities of the production. We produced a sample batch of briquettes in March 2020 with their assistance. These were sent out to industries on the Delhi-Haryana border, who then responded with positive feedback.
Our entrepreneurs will be supported by a corollary income growth of 106%, while charcoal retails for 8,500 per ton and briquettes for 6,000 per ton. Dhreya briquettes will be retailed at Rs 4,000 per ton, making them a more economical choice. Through the sale of 180 tons of briquettes, we'll be able to record an annual revenue of Rs 7,20,000 initially, directly impacting the lives of 30 community members and indirectly impacting 127 others.
Project Dhreya aims to save a whopping 180 tons of stubble from being burnt by converting them into briquettes. Briquettes have a higher calorific value and energy density is proliferated by 6 times. Biomass briquettes on average save 30 to 40% of boiler fuel cost and have a lower ash content in comparison to other fuels, making them a sustainable choice. The negligible carbon dioxide emitted from burning these briquettes has neutral effects due to its photosynthetic uptake during plant growth.
Briquettes are often used for co-firing in industrial operations, which help in reducing the overall carbon footprint.
Sessions focusing on government schemes, finance management and product development are held regularly to ensure holistic development of the community. Collaborating with IARI, we have successfully conducted workshops on advanced agricultural techniques which would facilitate a higher crop yield. Under the difficult circumstances of a pandemic, we have been in constant touch with our community in order to ensure their well-being.
Project Dhreya takes a step towards sustainable development by aligning with 5 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals.
Project Dhreya holds immense potential. Keeping COVID-19 in mind, our workspace will be fully compliant with government guidelines. Protective gear will be provided to all workers and social distancing will be strictly maintained.
Once we stabilize and scale up production, our long-term goals include producing briquettes from multiple crop wastes and expanding the model by setting up nodal production centers across India. With growing environmental consciousness, the demand for briquettes is expected to rise in the future. Project Dhreya is fueled by the purpose, patience and perseverance of our farmers and members. Project Dhreya saw an opportunity to improve living conditions by utilizing agricultural waste, which is not normally seen as an asset.
Clearing up the smog and sowing the seeds of Enactus, Dhreya has paved the way for change and sustainability.
With 4 successfully running projects, 50 perseverant team members, more than 10,250 working hours and 80 established entrepreneurs, Enactus Miranda House has truly come a long way.
From overcoming environmental hazards to endeavouring the rejuvenation of dwindling self-esteem, our team has sought social and economic reformation in every project initiated by us.
When the vision goes beyond achieving success, true change begins.
Our inspiration comes from the knowledge that besides pioneering social change, our commitment extends to make this world a better place.
We seek opportunities.
We aim
at achieving excellence.
We strive
to bring change.
Yeah!